A few minutes after the International Criminal Court released its verdict, President Uhuru Kenyatta joined millions of Kenyans in celebrating the vindication of his deputy, William Ruto, and his co-accused Joshua Arap Sang. In a statement, President Kenyatta said the moment was long overdue, but no less joyful. The head of state, who is in Paris, France, for a state visit, maintained that many victims await justice and perpetrators are yet to be brought to book. But even as President Kenyatta welcomed the decision, he reiterated that his government will continue to work on healing the nation, uniting people, reconciling communities, and ensuring that justice for the victims is achieved.
This decision brings to a close what has been a nightmare for the Kenyan nation. With the conclusion of this case at the ICC, our country is fully back on focus to enhance our efforts towards nation building, promoting peace and security. For the Deputy President and the President, this focuses fully on the affairs of running the state, a mandate given to the President and the Deputy President by the Kenyan people.
Other leaders also joined the President in celebrating the decision by ICC to terminate the cases. The leader of Majority National Assembly, Adan Duale, took to Twitter to send his message, while Elgeyo Marakwet Senator Kipchumba Murkomen also posted his message on Twitter. In Eldoret, the town came to a standstill with celebrations reverberating across the town from the locals after the ICC gave its verdict.
Just happy, just very happy, 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 happy. Hatuna ya kuongeza ingine. ICC wametenda haki, tumefurahi.
Siku ya leo tumeona kwamba haki imetendeka. Kwa hakika ilikuwa uchungu kwa watu wa Wasingishu na pia kwa Kenya mzima kwa kusungusha watu kwa miaka sita ambayo hawana hatia.
The Attorney General, Professor Githu Muigai, also joined other leaders in welcoming the termination of the ICC case that faced Deputy President William Ruto and journalist Joshua Arap Sang. Professor Muigai, in a statement, noted that ICC has finally been guided by the rule of law and upheld the clear substance and spirit of the Rome Statute. And here in Nairobi, a majority of Kenyans who spoke to Channel One welcomed the decision, even as a few individuals questioned the fate of the victims of the post-election violence.
No one is getting their rights. And there's so many IDPs around. Plus, no one is justified to get off the leash like that. Plus, I definitely think it will probably affect the election, but we won't feel it as much.
I agree the rule out that has been done, they knew what they did, and they were best in the position to rule it out. We don't know what exactly was said there, and there's no way we will say that this was wrong, this was right, but we accept and we leave it. God knows better why it was ruled out, and we are happy for it to end this way. For the IDP people, I do feel you, I feel how you feel, and I'll urge you, forget the past, to gange ajayo.
The International Criminal Court ICC has made public its verdict. Ruto and Sang have no case to answer. It is celebratory mood across the country, even as questions linger on who will give justice to the victims of the 2007-2008 post-election violence. In his congratulatory message to the Deputy President, Court Leader Raila Odinga says it is time for Kenya to come together as a country and ensure justice for the victims. Reporting for KBC Channel 1 from Nairobi County, I'm Roncliffe Odit.